It's Monday, 27th of April. I've had first night back home since Henry was born. First night on my own in a completely empty house, which is a bit strange. Kate is still in hospital after having her op. In Ashford now though with Henry, which is nice. So I'm getting feedback from that. He's still stable, had a, all accounts, seems to have had a decent night, so that's all positive. Mum's feeling a little bit delicate today. A few pains from the op now, sort of coming through, bruising and stuff. So I think she's had a little struggle. She's had a tough night as well, because she's had an allergic reaction to some of the meds. So just to make life a bit more interesting for her. She's been itching like crazy, but they've now got her on a drip to sort that out. So hopefully she'll feel a bit better today. Just waiting on a parcel to arrive so that I can then head off back to the hospital to go and see both Mum and Henry. Hopefully get some news that he's still progressing. The four kids that live with us are coming home today, so it'll be a bit more crazier here. A bit more normality for them as well, because I think everyone's sort of struggling a little bit with being separated. It's tough, especially I'd say, with all the extra restrictions at the moment. But it's for the best. But I say it's a bit more normality today with kids being back here. Silas trying to stay in contact with my other children much as I can too, to keep them updated on what's going on. I don't, the littler ones don't fully understand, but it's still nice to try and let them know that he's okay. Yeah, very, very tired. Feeling a little bit more positive today, a bit more cheery. Like to sort of make a point of also saying thanks to everyone that's messaged over the last couple of days via Facebook, text, it's all sorts of social media messages. Just really grateful, we're all grateful for all the messages. there's been a few times where I haven't responded to people, or we haven't responded, we're not trying to be ignorant. It's just sometimes it's either a lot going on, so it's finding the time to reply. Also, it's not always easy to know what to say, because people ask how Henry is. I can't give much away, to be honest, because I don't know myself. I can only get so much jargon thrown at me in a day and take it all in, medical wise. All I can say is, at present, he's in a stable position. He's getting all the help he can get to build him up, and just the next few days are just really important to get his lungs fully up to where they need to be. So Mum's getting to go and visit him, so that's nice. She can tell him that we're all wanting to keep fighting. As far as Kate and myself and our well-being, we're as well as we can be. We have ups and downs. There has been tears, there has been sort of happy moments. It is difficult to take it all on board. Personally, I try to sort of try and stay as strong as I can to support Kate. But I am okay. I have had a few of emotional meltdowns, but all in all I'm all right, so thanks for everyone that's asked. Yeah, that's kind of about it this morning. Just want this parcel to bloody hurry up now so that I can get on my way. yeah, so I'll try and take more pictures and videos and stuff so that I can keep things updated of his progress as best I can. It's difficult for me now, not being allowed in to see him, but I will do my best to keep everyone and updated and as I can, really. So that's about it for this morning. Just had a little FaceTime with Bella and the girls to try and explain to them a little bit about what's going on with their little baby brother. It's quite tough to explain because they're very young. Finding it all quite tough myself at the moment. Missing all the kids. It's a really difficult situation at the moment, what with being locked down as well, and not seeing all the children. Got to try and sort of stay positive and hope it's not too much longer till we can all be back together. Still waiting to be able to leave to go to the hospital, so that's not helping either. It's really difficult. Oh. But yeah, just the girls gave him a bit of a briefing as to what's going on with Henry and how he needs help with his breathing and things. But they're obviously so young, it's quite difficult and hard to explain because I don't want to scare them or upset them either. Just looking forward to a big cuddle with all of them, really. The older two, Olivia and Oscar, and I've spoke to them on FaceTime, they kind of understand what's going on. But it's still tough. I know that Kate's kids, especially Lucy, she's finding it all very tough at the moment because we all just kind of want answers, but obviously they can't tell us what they don't know. I think everyone's kind of missing each other, being separated, especially at the moment with Kate in the hospital and Kate's kids at their grandmum's, grandparents. My kids with their mums and on lockdown, it's quite a struggle. So, but it's as much as it's difficult doing these videos because I do feel a bit silly, but at the same time, it's quite nice to be able to talk and open up because sometimes it's hard to kind of explain. So I have people asking me how I am and how I'm feeling. I don't really know myself. I'm just up and down at the moment. Just trying to stay strong and stay focused, really. But sometimes the emotions get the better of me. On the 27th of April, I arrived at the hospital very positive to see what progress my little boy had made. As I arrived at Kate's room, I entered the door to find her crying on the phone to her mum. What came to follow after that was quite a hard, tough, heartbreaking moment. Henry had a really bad sort of spell during the night and fallen very ill. We shed a lot of tears and found it really difficult not knowing if our little boy would pull through. Together we sat, cuddled, cried, and I just tried to reassure Kate as best I could that our little boy was a fighter. He wasn't going to give up. He'd hit a low point, but it wasn't the end. We had to believe that little Henry could still fight, despite being so very, very poorly.
If God had granted me a son, the summers die one by one, also they fly on and on, and I am old and will be gone. Bring him peace, bring him joy. He is young, he is only a boy. You can take, you can give. Let him be, let him live. If I die, let me die.
As the door opened to Kate's room, both our hearts sank as we heard the voice of Henry's main carer. But thankfully, as she entered the room, she handed us a massive moment of hope. Our little boy had decided to carry on fighting and wasn't giving up.
We got our first official baby picture of little baby Henry. They then agreed for me to have half hour with him in the NICU ward, which was absolutely amazing. It was just so nice just to have that little bit of quality time with my little boy.
Day of very mixed emotions. When I first arrived at the hospital to come to see Kate and baby, we hadn't had the best of news. Henry had had quite a tough little spell, become quite poorly, and was struggling quite a bit with his blood pressure. And wasn't sure how well he was. He was very, very poorly. As the day's gone on, we have had more positive news that he's had a good afternoon. He's now off meds for his blood pressure. And later on today, they're going to take him off the sedation medicine. So hopefully get to see him open his little eyes and see him with a little wiggle around. Obviously still, his lungs are still very weak. And still a lot of work and a long way to go there. But it's been a bit more positive this afternoon. I did actually get to spend half hour with my boy today, which was an amazing moment for me, considering we were told that I wouldn't really be allowed, and I sort of said I'd have half hour with him. So that was amazing, just to get to hold his little hands, which was tiny, expected.
Yeah, so it's been about mixed emotions. I go home, pick up the other children from their grandparents, Lucy, Daniel, Amy and Jack, take them home, a bit of normality at home, and be back again to the hospital tomorrow. Back home after another long day at the hospital. We've got a bit of normality. We've got more kids, so it's not so quiet today in the house. A bit more normality, and very exhausting. But feeling a bit more positive, and looking forward to a good night's sleep and start again. Another adventure for a long day tomorrow.
Support and love you've had for me on social media is absolutely amazing.
I'd like to thank everyone for their comments, their messages, and just all the love and support he's been given. It just helps us feel good and keeps our spirits up, keeps us really happy. So it's really lovely. So thank you so much.